What's going on, my PT peeps and my Walking Dead family? Welcome to the PT channel. I'm One Eye Bry. You don't know if I'm winking or I'm blinking, but I'm definitely thinking about the Walking Dead season 9 finale that just aired a couple minutes ago. So obviously, spoiler warning for the season 9 finale of the Walking Dead. If you haven't seen it, go watch it, come back, let me know. I'm going to recap it a little bit, review it, tell you my thoughts, what I liked, what I thought was great, and what I hope for next season for sure. But season 9 is done overall. It was a great season of The Walking Dead, and I can't wait for season 10. Season 9, episode 16, The Storm. And that's what we saw, a storm, a blizzard for sure. In the aftermath of an overwhelming loss, the communities must brave a ferocious blizzard as one group deals with an enemy from within, another is forced to make a life or death decision. So the life or death decision was going through the Whisperer border. The kingdom has fallen. Ezekiel was talking over the radio to, I guess, recruit everybody to come help him move the people from the kingdom because there was a time jump. It was a couple months from the fair that went by, and it was one of those things where, like, wait a second, why is Michonne there? And I guess they helped them move everyone from the kingdom to the hilltop in Alexandria. So clearly Henry was the focus of some problem with Carol and Ezekiel, and it's understandable for sure. And I love the nice little touches like young Henry there, and really the box of Henry mementos, the Shiva pin, the card for his birthday, Prince Henry. And it was just cool. It was a nice little callback to see Henry where he was and Carol remembering him from when he was a little kid to when he was an older kid. And I mean, really was a teenager. And it's kind of cool that the Lentz kids, Maxon and Matt, both played Henry, young Henry and older Henry, which is a nice little fun fact too. And it's just a shame that Henry, you know, his death is going to cause this problem between Carol and Ezekiel, and I guess Daryl as well. But you see the Shiva pin and the blue car, and it was just kind of a cool thing. But I feel bad for Carol and Ezekiel because losing a child or having any stress in a relationship like this, how can you overcome it? You can't bring Henry back. So what's going to be the factor that brings these two together? I don't think anything, right? I mean, you can't really have anything to replace a child that you lost. So how can you two move forward? And it's a shame. And it's a shame that Ezekiel is blaming Carol and Daryl and not really Alpha. That's the person you should blame. So we'll see if that comes around in season 10. Hopefully, you know, Ezekiel does fight the Whisperers and they got the charter. And it was a little sad when you saw Tara's name on the charter. And that takes me to the possible theory that it's cursed. The charter is cursed. Whoever signed it, they could be in trouble. But the kingdom has fallen, and I'm not sure they're ever going to go back to it. Especially when Ezekiel talked with Judith about at the end, you can go back there someday. And Ezekiel was like, it's not where you are, it's who you're with. And the kingdom is about the people. The kingdom can be anywhere. It doesn't have to be at the actual kingdom. And Jerry's funny line about King Top was pretty funny. But Ezekiel is leaving the kingdom, and I'm not sure if we're ever going to go back there. And you could see the fires that burned up the roofs and the roof damage and stuff. And then they start their trek back to Alexandria and Hilltop, and they had to stop at a way station and then the sanctuary, which was kind of cool to go back there. And it was interesting because, you know, we haven't seen winter on the show, but to me, it was like this was the worst blizzard I've ever seen. And in some areas, it was snowing really hard. In other areas, there really was barely any snow. And then you saw the Whisperers camp, they didn't have any snow. So the continuity was a little off, but I could see what they're doing building for season 10 and beyond. And I kind of felt bad for Carol and Lydia and Ezekiel, and Daryl's put in a bad situation. I mean, he didn't ask for this, and he didn't even ask for the whole Henry situation. Carol brought that on him. And then Henry went after Lydia, and Daryl had to go protect them, and it was just a tough situation. But the walkers were pretty cool. The frozen walkers were awesome. These walkers were pretty cool. If you just look at the detail, it was like, man, these zombie popsicles and zombie-sicles and walker-sicles, just look at the detail. It was pretty cool. But again, the continuity was a little off. Some of them are frozen, and then other ones are covered by the snow, and they're moving pretty quickly at Daryl and Ezekiel and stuff. And then they basically want to just put the icicle through the eye, which was pretty cool. But I really didn't like the point that Ezekiel was making to Daryl, and he did come across like he's not trying to be a bad guy, but he's trying to work on things with Carol, but it's a big mess. And the whole Lydia situation, I'm sure everyone blames Lydia, even though she's not to blame. It's Alpha. She didn't do any of this, but they don't care. The group's going to be against her, and I can understand that. But at the end, we see Carol, Daryl, and Lydia at Alexandria. So they're away from those people. So we'll see how it goes down going forward. And Lydia wanted to have the walker bite her, couldn't do it. Carol couldn't take her out, and it's just a big mess. I just wonder what the storyline is going to be like going forward. And I have to say, I really enjoyed the snow aspect on the show. It was finally here, and it was definitely cool to see. And I'm not sure if we're ever going to see it again, because they've been trying to get snow on for many seasons, and it was just kind of cool to see this. So I think it's probably the one and done episode that we're going to get snow, because it probably took a lot for this to get it on the street and then on the studio and then around. But it was funny when Magnum was like, people actually live here, because the sanctuary is a dump, and it was kind of cool that they went back there. I like the aspect that they kind of went full circle. The beginning of the second half of season 9, Negan got out, went to the sanctuary. At the end of season 9, they went back to the sanctuary and saw it again. So is the sanctuary ever going to be used again? I doubt it. As for Mr. Sanctuary, Negan was pretty hilarious. But I got a question for everyone. Where did Dog go? I mean, when everybody was moving from the one place to Aaron's house, it just seemed like it was so far in Alexandria. Like, Alexandria was this big giant complex with so much land and so much stuff. And then Judith went after Dog. And I guess they were on the Alexandria property, right? I mean, he didn't get outside and go there, and Negan got hit by a flying piece of wood and hurt his leg, and it was basically setting up the redemption arc story. It's a little far-fetched, but I could see what they were doing, and I love the snowball fight, and I definitely love the aspects with Judith on the show. And I found it interesting that Negan brought up the joke, like, you know, Father Gabriel, you're the father, but not the father, and what's going on with Sadiq when he's there, you know, being the doctor to the mother of his child? You know, it was kind of interesting aspect, and I wonder if it's going to come up again. But Father Gabriel's like, we're all adults here. And I wonder what's going to happen with Eugene, Father Gabriel, Sadiq, and Rosita. Because are they all going to survive? If you know the comics, you know some big stuff could definitely happen. It was kind of cool that we saw RJ having some snowball fight, and that was a good little moment. It was very nice to see them just playing around in the snow. And hopefully RJ gets more and more screen time and more of a role. But as for Lydia, I kind of feel bad for her. She has no place, whether it's Hilltop, Kingdom, or Alexandria. What is going to be her storyline? Because right now, I don't know. And the blizzard was crazy. At Alexandria, it's snowing, a ferocious blizzard. And when they go through the pikes, it's snowing. But when they get to the frozen lake, no snow whatsoever. Did you catch the thing with Michonne? She said, anything from Maggie? I wonder if that was her on the radio. Or was it Jadis? It was definitely hard to tell, and it was super quick. So I'll have to wait and see for next season. What's in store for Ezekiel and Carol? You got Ezekiel at Hilltop, and you got Carol at Alexandria. I mean, that's not good for a relationship if you're not living together, right? And I guess the relationship is over. Carol wanted to give back the ring. Ezekiel said, keep it. So I wonder what's going to happen there. And I just feel like something's going to happen to Ezekiel right away. I thought something would happen to Ezekiel here, but nothing happened. We didn't lose anybody, which is good. We lost enough last episode, right? But when they were going through the blizzard Alexandria, they were all tied together. And I felt like it was such the longest walk ever from the building to Aaron's place. And I guess it would be hard to see, so they were all, you know, roped together, which is a good idea. But again, the blizzard was just crazy. It was snowing like crazy at Alexandria and then there. And I guess it was like different times of the blizzard. You know, different areas might have different snowfall for sure. But the pikes were still up. They crossed the border. And even if the Whisperers didn't see them, there's going to be tracks in the snow, right? I mean, there was a bunch of tracks, and it could be a walker group, but the Whisperers aren't going to, like, think that it was a walker group. And if they see the tracks, and if they see the dead walkers, which they probably will, they're going to know that the border was crossed, and there's going to be a problem. And if you know the comics, you know the Horde is coming for Alexandria and Hilltop, and that should be pretty amazing for the Whisperer War in Season 10. But the frozen walkers were awesome, the three that were standing there. And it's like, there's no way they were going to be Whispers because they were frozen for sure. But then when they were going towards the frozen lake, the walkers did their thing where they're kind of there, and then someone gets close to them, and then they magically just pop out of the snow right when they're there, right? I mean, that's the little thing they have to do for drama and selling it for sure. But Daryl was the hero, of course, and they got everybody home. I didn't see Connie. I saw Magna and Yumiko, but I didn't see Luke. I didn't see a couple other characters for sure. Diane was there at the beginning, but, you know, some characters were there more prominent than others. But Daryl's going to have a bigger and bigger role in Season 10, for sure. And overall, Season 9 was great, for sure, and I'm excited for Season 10. We just got to wait till October. Another question I have is, how did the Whisperers not have any snow whatsoever here? You would think, oh, maybe it was a time jump for going forward, but then Ezekiel was on the radio talking to Judith, like, we will get through the winter months. So did they jump ahead without the snow, or was it a mistake or a plot hole? But either way, the Whisperers are coming to Alexandria most likely and Hilltop with the Walker Horde. And the big thing at the end was, hello, hello, is anyone there? And then it's over. What did you make of it? Is it Jadis? Is it Maggie? Is it Georgie? I think it's Jadis, but we'll have to wait all summer to find out in October. And that's what they want to do. Little cliffhanger, not a big deal. We'll see how it goes down, if it's a connection with Rick in the movies, or Georgie in the Commonwealth, or this or that. Can't wait to find out. So let me know your thoughts. Post your comments below. Overall, I thought the episode was okay, and I just see some things about some questions. But overall, season 9 was great. I'm excited for Fear the Walking Dead that starts June 2nd. The Walking Dead will return in October, and we're definitely going to cover filming season that starts end of April, early May, all the way to November. So stay tuned for many more videos. And if you haven't already, guys, please hit that subscribe button and join our PT channel, Walking Dead Family. And remember, guys, with hard work, dedication, belief, and sacrifice, you can truly achieve your goals. Believe in yourself. You can do it. It's about love, support, staying positive, making memories. And as always, tell them, Daryl.
Yo, we love you guys. Honestly, thank you.